This is the last part of the videos related to diabetes mellitus. In this video, we will learn about the treatment of all types of diabetes mellitus. Type 1 diabetes can't be prevented right now. However, there are effective ways to prevent type 2 diabetes and to avoid serious problems and early deaths that can come from all types of diabetes. This involves adopting healthy practices everywhere, like in school, homes, and workplaces, that help everyone stay healthy, not just people with diabetes. These healthy practices include regular exercise, eating well, not smoking, and keeping blood pressure and cholesterol under control. The best way to manage diabetes well is to catch it early. The longer someone has diabetes without knowing and treating it, the worse their health will become. It's important that tests to check blood sugar levels are easy to get at local health centers. People with diabetes might also need to see specialists regularly to check for and treat any complications. There are cost-effective steps that can improve the health of people with any type of diabetes. These include managing blood sugar through diet, exercise, and sometimes medicine, keeping blood pressure and cholesterol in check to lower the risk of heart disease and other issues, and regularly checking for damage to the eyes, kidneys, and feet to get treatment early if needed. Tests for type 1 and type 2 diabetes and pre-diabetes. A1C test. This blood test shows average blood sugar level for the past 2 to 3 months. It measures the percentage of blood sugar attached to hemoglobin. It's also called a glycated hemoglobin test. The higher the blood sugar level, the more hemoglobin will be glycated. An A1C level of 6.5% or higher on 2 separate tests confirms diabetes. An A1C between 5.7 and 6.4 is a pre-diabetes status. Below 5.7 is considered normal. Random blood sugar test. A blood sugar level of 200 milligrams per deciliter or 11.1 millimoles per liter or higher suggests diabetes. Fasting blood sugar test. A fasting blood sugar level less than 100 milligrams per deciliter or 5.6 millimoles per liter is normal. A fasting blood sugar levels from 100 to 125 milligram per deciliter, 5.6 to 6.9 millimoles per liter is considered pre-diabetes. If it is 126 milligram per deciliter or 7 millimoles per liter or higher on 2 separate tests, it confirms diabetes. Glucose tolerance test. For this test, the fasting blood sugar level is measured, followed by drinking a sugary liquid, and blood sugar levels are tested regularly for the next 2 hours. A blood sugar level less than 140 milligrams per deciliter or 7.8 millimoles per liter is normal. A reading of more than 200 milligrams per deciliter, that is 11.1 millimoles per liter, after 2 hours suggests diabetes. A reading between 140 and 199 milligram per deciliter, that is 7.8 millimoles per liter and 11 millimoles per liter, suggests pre-diabetes. For type 1 diabetes, urine tests may be performed to look for the presence of ketones. Ketones are a byproduct produced when muscle and fat are used for energy. Autoantibodies may be checked in the blood to rule out type 1 diabetes. In the first or second trimester of pregnancy, diabetes screening should be performed for gestational diabetes. Treatment for all types of diabetes. Healthy eating. A diabetic diet is recommended, which is basically a healthy eating plan to control blood sugar. It comprises of more fruits, vegetables, lean proteins, and whole grains. Besides this, cutting down of saturated fats, refined carbohydrates, and sweets is recommended. A regular aerobic activity is mandatory. It may include walking, swimming, or biking. Treatment for type 1 diabetes involves insulin injections or the use of an insulin pump. Pancreas transplant may be an option. Treatment of type 2 diabetes mostly involves lifestyle changes, oral diabetes drugs, insulin, or both. Monitoring of blood sugar. Daily blood sugar monitoring and regular A1C testing to measure average blood sugar level for the past 2 to 3 months are highly recommended. Insulin is the only treatment for type 1 diabetes. However, it may be required to treat many type 2 diabetes patients or cases of gestational diabetes. Insulin is available in different forms, including short-acting, rapid-acting, long-acting insulin, and intermediate. Insulin is administered only in injectable form, as stomach enzymes interfere with insulin's action if taken in oral form. An insulin pump is also available. The pump is a small device worn on the outside of the body. A tube connects the pump to a catheter that's inserted under the skin of the abdomen. Oral hypoglycemic drugs. Some oral hypoglycemic drugs help pancreas to release more insulin. Others prevent the production and release of glucose from the liver. Some block the action of digestive enzymes that break down carbohydrates, slowing their absorption or making tissues more sensitive to insulin. Another class of medication called SGLT2 inhibitors may be used. These work by preventing the kidneys from reabsorbing filtered sugar into the blood. Instead, the sugar is eliminated in the urine. A pancreas transplant may be an option. Islet transplants are under research as well, but transplants are not very successful and associated with high risks. A lifetime of immune-suppressing drugs need to be taken to prevent rejection. These drugs are associated with many serious side effects. Therefore, transplants are usually reserved for uncontrolled cases or those who also need a kidney transplant. Bariatric surgery. Some people with type 2 diabetes who are obese with a body mass index over 35 might benefit from certain types of weight loss surgery. Those who have had a surgery called gastric bypass often experience significant improvements in their blood sugar levels. However, the long-term advantages and risks of this surgery for treating type 2 diabetes are still unclear. Managing gestational diabetes is essential to keep the baby healthy and also to avoid complications during delivery. The management is same as for diabetic patients. Pre-diabetes is usually managed by healthy lifestyle choices. Keeping a healthy weight through regular physical activity and healthy diet can help. Thank you for listening. If you like the video, make sure to drop a like. Let me know if you have any suggestions in the comments below. You can also buy my book on general pathology lecture notes. It will be greatly beneficial for students wanting to quickly revise basic concepts of general pathology. The link is given below in the comments.